On Times Now's News Hour debate number two points of view. I'd like to place on record there is no Congress representative on this debate tonight for a second consecutive night. The Congress party has not sent a representative on this important issue of whether there should be a disclosure on Blue Star. We have asked them and they have not sent it, not for want of trying. KC Singh, former Secretary, Ministry of External Affairs, and with him, Brigadier Israr Rahim Khan, for a second time on the News Hour tonight on this controversial subject, are on one side. I presume on the other side, we have Maheshinder Singh Grewal, who is an advisor to the Chief Minister of Punjab. And we also have Nirmala Sitharaman, National Spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party. And in the middle on this, and my first question goes to Hartosh Singhbal, senior journalist. Hartosh, should there be disclosure? Should there be a reinvestigation? Should there be an opening up? Will that serve a purpose or will that only add to the fire?
Arnab, absolutely there should be disclosure. The new evidence, what has come out in the UK, sheds a completely new light in what has happened in the run-up to Operation Blue Star. Clearly, the Indian government from February onwards was contemplating moving into the complex. Given this background, the lack of evidence, the lack of planning, the last-minute botch-ups of the army, the badly planned operation, all this is inexplicable. A man like R.N. Khao is sitting there giving advice, picking up intelligence, and yet this is what the army does. How do we put all this together? There has to be some explanation of how, as a nation, we end up commit such a blunder.
Well, Hartosh, let's get KC from the other side at first, because KC Singh's point of view is that it's not necessary now. I presume I got you right there right now. He also says he's worried that the issue will become political and get politicized, and that those who are making it political don't understand the nuances of how there is cooperation between different governments. KC, your counter on why you feel there should not be a disclosure.
No, let me say, Arnab, I have nothing against an inquiry, a full disclosure. In fact, the government can do it. But my point is they have nothing to fear.
Nothing to fear?
The government. What is wrong in... Let me give you an example. 1979, the Grand Mosque at Makkah was taken over by 500 militants, November of 1979. No non-Muslim is allowed inside Makkah. They got a special dispensation for the French paratroopers to come in because the Saudis did not have the capability. They deny it. They've denied it after that. But there is anecdotal evidence that the French were there. They went in. Now you take there were weapons available to people who were roaming around the Parikarma.
Yes.
That there was a competitive whipping of the sentiments of the Sikhs by the two sons. Sant Longowal was here. Sant Bindranwale was there. This was going on from December. After December, once they allowed Sant Bindranwale to move to the Akal Takht, there were only bad options or worse options. There were just no good options available because there was no way he was going to get out, and it was just going down the slope. I joined Rashtrapati Bhavan in October. Till November, December, there was the Commonwealth Heads of Government Summit. The central government was completely preoccupied with that.
The point is, by the way, we have some calls here from the Congress party which have been received from the news desk, and they are saying that you're putting out there that for a second consecutive night the Congress representatives are not on the News Hour, and they say that their point of view is that today there wasn't someone available for this subject, and that's why they don't have someone. It does not mean that they are avoiding a subject.
May I just conclude?
We are fair and balanced, I'm putting that point of view tonight. Yeah. However, KC Singh,
I'm saying there are mistakes There are multiple mistakes made and we need to learn from them.
No.
There was a mistake in terms of delaying action till December. There were mistakes made on the other side where they allowed the weaponization maltreatment of Sikhs in Haryana maltreatment of Sikhs during Asian Games.
That's not the
mistakes
issue.
Galore. That, and therefore, let's not single things out
that's
and just
not
whip
the
up sentiments.
No, that's not the issue tonight. Yeah. You see, the issue tonight is very different. The issue tonight is that my government is hiding something from me. I am an Indian citizen and I have a foreign government document which says about this secret visit of a military advisor, and I quote it. It says, it was therefore vital that there should be no leak about the visit. If there were a leak of the military advisor of Britain's visit to India, it would be extremely embarrassing for both sides And if the leak sprang from us, the Indians would never forgive us. 30 years on, the UK has told us what they were doing. My government is hiding things from me about the involvement of a foreign power in an internal security issue. Nirmala Sitharaman wants to contradict you. Nirmala Sitharaman to KC Singh.
And I can understand KC Singh's point because it's a matter of sensitivity and everything else. But it is an internal matter.
Yes.
Internal law and order issue, or you call anything else. And in that, if you're seeking, or if you sought, or if you didn't seek, let us hear it from our government. The declassification happened in the UK, as a result of which we first of all get to know something, and then the UK government does a very quick investigation and the statement is made in the House of Commons there. And now we are still waiting for our government to tell us whether they indeed sought or not.
Absolutely.
Why don't it say, the lessons that you're talking about, the learning that you're talking about.
Brigadier.
The learning that you're talking about is learned only after the facts come out.
Exactly. Brigadier Israr Khan wants to come in. I want to put a fact here, Brigadier Israr Khan, that the UK Cabinet Secretary's findings say that the Indian request for a contingency plan for possible armed action inside the Golden Temple was quote-unquote urgent, and the UK decided to honour it because it wanted to maintain close relationships with India. I want my government, as an Indian citizen, to tell me, what was this urgency? Why were you compelled to seek foreign intervention in that matter?
For an internal matter.
For an internal matter. It's a question of my sovereignty. Yes. Brigadier Israr Khan, respond to Nirmala Sitharaman.
You see, at the outset, I would like to repeat what I said yesterday.
Which is?
Indian Army has no objection to any files being opened in India.
Yeah.
To reveal the truth as to what advice was sought and what was given and how it was interacted within an army. So I will leave that part. Now coming to first comment made by Hartosh, your fellow journalist,
yes,
that it was a badly planned ops, and in his tone and tenor, I found Hartosh, he mentioned that it was a badly planned army operation, the Blue Star.
Yes.
And he also, in his tone and tenor, revealed that he is not quite happy with the conduct of the army. Let me first say that it couldn't have been planned better, Hartosh. Firstly, given the circumstances, I wonder if you know exactly what were the conditions. Only that you have read it in books and papers and all the things which have
but
come
that's
out.
That's not really the issue here.
The issue is that was it a badly planned operation?
She's
with due respects for the army, and it is not a question of the operations, whether it was tactically well-planned
yes.
or not. It is a question of a political decision which was taken by the government then.
Yeah.
And today, as Indian citizens, with greatest transparency and everything else, and with due respects for the army...
Madam, it is in the interest of the army that the truth comes out
so that the army
also feels better.
No, that's exactly, sir. With due respects to the army and the civilian, the relationship that the army and the civilian government holds in India, I would want the Indian political decision makers to come out clean. It is not casting aspersions on the army.
Yes.
It's more a political decision which the government of India has to explain.
Absolutely.
That is about it.
He also said that we sought... The Indian Army sought
I'm on a very serious point. First of all, Hartosh, just coming to you, I want to clarify one thing. I said yesterday, I do not question the valor, the commitment, the sacrifice shown by you in fighting terrorists. And let me be clear that they were terrorists. I underline that. Okay. My second point here is, however, I want to know whether my army was kept in the loop about the advice from the British government.
No, it did not.
No, so
it was not kept in the loop at all.
Isn't that a crime?
Yes, let it be investigated why the government held that.
So what was the political compulsion?
Yes.
Maheshinder Singh, Hartosh wants to first counter. Hartosh wanted to counter. Maheshinder Singh ji, I'm coming to you. I know that you are going to raise the issue politically. But Hartosh first wants to respond to Brigadier Israr Khan.
I am not in disagreement with Brigadier Israr. What I am saying is that there was considerable planning by the Indian administration. None of it seems to have been passed on to the army, which is informed at the last moment. I'll take you to Appendix E of the reply filed yesterday in British Parliament, and the exact statement of a senior intelligence official on June 13th is quoted there. It says, although some recommendations were used, the main concept changed once the Indian army took over. A frontal assault was attempted using some of the Indian Special Forces. the person concerned, the Indian intelligence officer, emphasized that a large number of deaths was not the result of the poor implementation of the plans, nor of any deficiency in the plans, but was due to the army's decision to do it their own way. So the intelligence wing of the Indian government is clearly blaming the army for the number of deaths that took place while talking to the UK counterparts. This is documented UK government.
I also want to raise another point here, and I'm now on a very serious point. Maheshinder Singh, I'm coming to you. My question is, and if you can just pay attention to this. My question is, the third question is, why is my Prime Minister explaining to their Prime Minister what she did? Now, you look, Indira Gandhi did not officially admit to UK's assistance in her letter. She wrote a letter to Margaret Thatcher. It was on 14th of June 1984, if I'm not mistaken, Hartosh. She explains why paramilitary troops were not used, right? And the army was sent in instead. Now, recall here that the military advisor had, as per the cabinet secretary's findings made public now, specifically spoken about coordination of paramilitary with Indian special group forces. My question is, Indira Gandhi, in her response to Thatcher, was indirectly explaining, almost in a submissive tone, why British advice was not adopted and the army was sent in instead. What's going on? Why is the Indian Prime Minister explaining in a beseeching tone? Please tell me, doesn't it worry you, KC Singh? Why is Indira Gandhi explaining to the UK why they did not go with the advice they had given? Look, I mean, it's a question again of our sovereignty.
Look, I'm not privy to what went on between the two prime ministers.
I can I have the letter.
No, but let me...
I have the letter.
Let me contextualize it. I think what happened after the event was there was an uproar in all countries wherever the Sikhs were resident, whether it was US, England, Canada, there was an uproar. There were demonstrations. Indian government was trying to explain their point of view, why they did what they did. And let me share with you another thing. After Mrs. Gandhi went there...
Why was Indian government explaining to the British government?
Because...
because what?
It is a public relations problem.
Public relations? You understand? Public relations? Nirmala Sitharaman?
It is not anything to do with public relations at all. You're explaining about your decisions, your political and strategic decisions, which is not necessary.
It was already in the public domain. Everything is in the public domain.
No, I'm sorry. Then why will a prime minister write?
Why will a public domain?
I don't know why she wrote. I'm simply telling you that at that point...
Why? It doesn't explain the question. In all countries, there were demonstrations taking place before Indian missions.
Very well, but then why should the Prime Minister in private explain it to the foreign countries?
Did the Prime Minister of India write to the Chinese Premier?
Let's not trivialize it.
No, I'm not trivializing it.
There are six in China, yeah.
So did the Prime Minister of India...
Did
the Prime Minister of India write to the Prime Minister of Canada?
I don't know. I'm simply telling you is that there was a public relations serious problem which our missions had in those countries where their large Sikh populations have continued to have that problem even today. Even today, the problem is there.
Public relations exercises will have a certain kind of explaining. Public relations exercises have a different kind of explanations to offer. They will not go into the details.
Maheshinder Singh Grewal from Ludhiana, who has the completely contrary perspective. Maheshinder Singh Grewal, you're hearing the arguments of KC Singh, former Secretary, Ministry of External Affairs, and Brigadier-retired Isra Rahim Khan, who was commanding officer of the 10 Guards Battalion that went into or did Operation Blue Star. Your response, are you convinced with their explanation that what was going on was probably normal, which is what KC Singh says?
Arnab, I totally disagree with it, because I think the perception of the people who served in the government for long is always for government. But reality remains, nation asked this explanation from the Congress leadership why they kept their own country in dark for that long, that they took the foreign assistance to attack the religious place of a minority and to that kill few persons who were claimed by them are terrorists, that they have to ask for British assistance. And it's more painful, Mr. Arnab, this issue has three angles. One,